I'm glad to see you made it. I had my doubts, but the hope you instilled has yet abandoned me.
I guess this must be Tarawea.
Who are you?
My name is Juan Luis Jorge, and this is indeed the convent of Tarawea. You'll have to excuse me, but Yermi never got your name.
The name's Edward Carnby. I'm a private investigator. You're not a patient, are you?
No. I'm the author of a book that Yermi once found important.
How does that work? Are you part of this memory as well? Is this even a memory?
I think calling me a manifestation of Yermi's subconscious would be more correct. And so is the convent of Tarawea. I'm a man Yermi has never met. And we are in a place that he has never been.
Okay. So are you here to guide me or something?
I have no more purpose than you do. I simply am. I will happily help you, of course, if I'm able.
If you are already somehow part of Jeremy, why did he want to come here? Isn't he sort of here already?
Yermi wanted to come here because it's a representation of his mind at peace. When Dr. Gray asks him to find his focus during his sessions, this far-flung convent is what Yermi imagines. He is under the impression that if he could physically come here, he would reach a perfect equanimity. A spiritual apotheosis.
You don't think it would work?
Yermi subconsciously knows it's just wishful thinking. He can't come here. Despite the pathways opened by the dark man between Derceto and Yermi's psyche, it's simply not possible.
But I'm here.
Indeed. It's a shame it's just another place for you, Detective. Otherwise, you could have become a Buddha.
Always a bridesmaid, never a blushing bride. Am I right?
Yes, I suppose so.
You'll have to chase enlightenment elsewhere.
So what's the next best thing? What can I do here?
You should seek out the convent library and try to find the truth about Yermi's relationship with the dark man. It's the sort of knowledge he represses and is unable to reflect on.
Will it tell me how to break the pact?
Perhaps. At least you'll have something to confront Yermi with.
Wait, why can't you just tell me?
I don't know such things. You'd be better off consulting the texts of Dr. Freud if you want such answers.
No thanks, I hate shrinks.
There is another thing you should know about the library. He is here as well. The dark man has been working his way through the text for a long, long time.
He's here? How am I supposed to get past him?
Be careful, Detective.
Oh, jeez, just perfect. What happened in here? Ugh. There's something missing.
Great library was it?
Thank you.
It was in the hot autumn that I went through the night with the restless crowds. He was a kind of itinerant showman who held forth in public halls and aroused widespread fear. The New Orleans address of the event is lost, but I remember distinctly the Prext Shipping Company pressing their contribution. Hey.
Detective!
What? What?
I hope you found what you were looking for. I fear there is no hope.
I was so close. There must be something I can work with. Come on, Carnby, think! Think! Right.
Good luck, Detective.
Well, thank God you're here, Detective. Sitting all alone in a place like this, I'd never live it down if the papers got wind of it.
Hey, Ruth, right?
Oh, don't pretend you don't know. I'm sure you have a whole file on me by now, Detective. I suppose we weren't formally introduced. I'm Ruth Talon, Miss Ruth Talon, in case you're wondering.
Edward Carnby.
Enchanté.
Are you sure?
I had too many already.
Nice. It's good.
I know. I have great taste, Detective. I heard you're trying to break Jeremy's promise to the dark man.
Yeah. Do you know anything about that kind of stuff?
No. But it makes you wonder. If he made a promise, can't he simply stand by his words?
Look, I'm just trying to get Jeremy out of a bad deal, so he'll come back with us to New Orleans.
Well, if all fails.
What are you doing?
It's a sign of submission to the dark man. I saw it in a dream once.
What? You don't know the Prext Shipping Company by any chance?
I do. They made big money during the war. Their waterfront office is just over there.
How did you do that?
Do what, Detective? Bonne chance.
Hey, have you seen Emily Hartwood anywhere?
Are you trying to make me jealous, Detective? No, I haven't seen your doll anywhere.
Prext Shipping Company. According to the book,
somehow Carnby was.
I'm sure I can find the address inside. It's locked from the other side. eyes. Be another way inside. Thank you. No way I can get this out of the way with my bare hands. But if I get that crane going, that should do it. Finished. Inside the warehouse. The office must be upstairs.
Our ship was raided while in dock. All of his things were recovered, but blood was shed. Several men were carried into the Mississippi River. Gotta go manifest, Tom.
Here we go. The address where Jeremy first encountered the Dark Man.
Gotta go manifest, Tom. September 19th, 1892. Breck Shipping Company delivered 4 steamer trunks, 1 Egyptian sarcophagus, and a large wooden crate belonging to the showman called the Black Pharaoh, performing at 18th Street.
Looks like the fog cleared up. You want to tell me what this is all about?
Welcome, Detective, to the greatest show this side of the Mississippi. Nalota, the Black Pharaoh, the ancient magician who lived 1,000 lives and wore 1,000 masks.
I can see why you settled on calling him the Dark Man. Saves your breath. So, you got scared by a stage magician, and now he's living inside your head.
You can mock me, Detective. You would be the crazy one to think his presence can be ignored. Look where we are!
We didn't get to finish our last conversation, did we? You were about to tell me how to break the contract with the Dark Man.
No, we can't. It would turn loose on the world. So many innocent would die.
But there is a way to break out of the deal.
There is. You offered me a way out. Steps to take.
What are they?
You'll never find them. They're forever entombed in his sunken desert temple.
Jeremy, I'm not your enemy. Tell me where to go. How do I find the temple?
No, we can't. I have to make this sacrifice.
God damn it, Jeremy. I'm gonna save you. Don't worry. sunken desert temple. I better get down there.
The Temple of Nefrenkar lies under our camp.
Here we go. Feeling this is it. This is where the contract is hidden. But how do I get to it?
The Temple of Nefrenkar lies under our camp. Despite all efforts, that unholy site did not collapse, but sink beneath the sand. The Pharaoh is long dead, his name meticulously stricken from all ancient writing. But that stage meant for blood and terror remains. The temple is said to be lightless, built to harbor all the haunters of the dark found. In the very depths of our universe. Calling on the gods meant creating a bridge between our world and theirs. The terrible Aldebaran of Taurus, the Black Sun, was seen as the most important star in the night sky. Because, according to the Kitab al-Azif, it was said to be the home of that crawling chaos known as Nyarlathotep. Through ancient mechanisms, it was said that the priests could open shafts channeling the light emitted by that strange stone called the Shining Trapezohedron. Several streams pooled together above the statue of that dark man would then be sent through space towards the Black Sun, a message to the gods. The gifts bestowed on the
the dog.
Stalk's operation.
Thank you.
ready to collapse.
Acknowledge psychological trauma, breakthrough barriers of self-deceit, temperamentic behavior. These are the Dark Man's terms. The contract. Huh?
Ah! Ah! Run! Ah!